On this episode of Story to Tell, we chat with the cool kids. We discuss their origins.
You know what I mean? One weekend, he just came from the suburbs, came up to the crib. We played some beats and shit. And then I was like, I made mention of it. I was like, yeah, you said you rap too, right? And he like, bet. He turned his hat backwards. And that man blacked out for like 30 straight minutes. And I was like, yeah, I ain't never heard nobody really rap like that. And then be securing what he was talking about, and the shit was fresh, and you know what I'm saying? Like, it was, I was like, all right, nah, yeah, we could do something. Like, let's do this. Because at my first idea was we'd be like Atmosphere, and I'd produce, and he'd be like Slug.
Being fashion trendsetters.
I would get, like, in the fights damn near all the time for dressing different in high school and stuff. Because, you know, out here in Chicago, especially in, like, the suburbs, everybody kind of get a little shook if somebody don't look the same as, you know, the status quo. And, you know, I was pulling up with Bapes and SBs and all of this crazy shit as a high schooler, and nobody knew what it was.
Their inspirations.
Crisscross jump video changed my motherfucking life. I don't know if I would have tried to be a football player or athlete or anything, but I saw that video and I saw that the clothes them boys had on, and I was like, my mama will never buy me this, but I'm about to be on tilt. And it wasn't that she couldn't afford it. Like, my mother, we weren't, you know what I mean? Like, it wasn't about the fashion choices or the jackets being $100. It was about motherfuckers in Detroit was getting killed for that shit. Like, you couldn't have what Chris Cross had on and go to any mall in Detroit at that time. And I was like, that shit is tight. I want to dress like that for the rest of my life.
Their new triple album.
I wanted shit to exist where people were listening to it and outside, and what was making, you know, the girls hit the dance floor, what was making everybody jump up and down at the concerts. And now that that has been taken out the equation for this album, it's like I got way more creative, because I can't shortchange it. I can't cut no corners, and nothing's working. So I'm not gonna try to make my version to no one, nothing current. I'm gonna just make my version of some shit and see what happens now.
And much more.
Kenna calls me on the phone with Justin Timberlake, like, gee, the Black Max video is the best video I ever seen. And I was like, oh, all right, well, I guess we're here now.
Watch the full interview, read the related article, and listen to the playlist for the full story. And check back often to the Coda Collection for more episodes of Story to Tell.